I love learning new stuff, and today, the youngest, newest researchers in the entire academy are presenting their latest information on posters, and I love posters, so let's see what they're doing. And I would like you to tell me about your research, because this is fascinating, but could you do it in the form of a haiku?
Can I do it in the form of a haiku?
Yes. So it's gain of function. Doesn't that make it better?
No.
All right, Giancarlo, I love a good poster session, but we don't have a lot of time. So can you tell me what your poster is about in four words?
Four words.
Just five syllables, seven syllables, five syllables. I mean, you're clearly a very smart person.
Yeah, you knew you were going to put me on the spot for this
So
one,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah, no, absolutely. How should I pronounce this word here? Line 95 tropophis? Yeah, we can work on it.
Let's work on it together. Can
okay,
we do
let's
that
come up
together?
With the first line.
That would be really
like,
helpful.
Like background would be our first six or five syllables.
Okay.
Can you explain your findings to me like I'm a like I'm a 3-year old? How would you explain this to a 3-year old?
Oh man, a 3-year old?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
So I mean, you're a pediatrician. You can do this. Here.
Yeah. Oh man. Okay. Where's your family from? Like, are you guys around? Like, do you travel a lot to other countries?
I'm 3.
Yeah.
So I don't know. I'm really interested in this poster because Williams syndrome is one of the top syndromes affecting anybody with syndromes.
That's not good.
Mental health on site.
Very nice.
All right.
Except it's really virtual. So it's not on site.
Mental
so now you're
health
like throwing me off.
Off-site.
Off-site.
If you're always getting exposed to other countries or you're traveling or you were born outside of the United States in some areas, you have a high risk of this disease. It's called tuberculosis. And it's
So we decided to establish a governance committee to corral all of those outdated guidelines.
Wait, okay, I'm getting really excited by this. Did you hire cowboys? Collaborative care.
Yes!
You discovered a completely new mutation leading to cardiac disease.
Yeah.
If you get to name it, what will you call it?
I would say...
Would you name it after yourself?
Jimmy.
Jimmy.
I love to be called Jimmy.
Okay. Jamshed, Jimmy. Look out for the Jimmy mutation, people. That is great. Do you have a cookie?
I have a cookie somewhere.
Okay. And then findings in five.
Well, it's got to be about kids. We're helping kids.
Yeah, it's got to be about the kids.
Kids.
Yeah. And this has to do with reducing class B infections. I think they're all class A. But Sarah, how does an infection get downgraded to a class B?
I guess I actually don't even know what would be a class A infection. So this is central line associated bloodstream infection. So we work to a multidisciplinary approach in a proactive safety manner to really drive down our infection rates in our cardiac ICU.
I am realizing I've made a horrible mistake. All right, guys, cut that because I'm not going to look really smart here. Let's not use this. All right. I know this is kind of complicated and we don't have a lot of time. So I'm wondering if you could explain this in three words.
Do your best.
Yes! And Laura, you are doing incredible things with patient portal work. I thought it might move them from one place to another. Apparently, it doesn't. But tell me what you are doing.
I'm looking at how clinicians and pediatric patients and or their proxies communicate. Specifically, I'm interested in how clinicians are responding to patient or proxy emotions.
So let me get this straight. You've got computer communication responding to emotion. Have you taught the computer to give somebody like a hug?
Helping kids stay, feel good.
Helping kids feel good. There you have it.
We got it.
One poster, one haiku.
That's what we're
doing. We don't even need all this.
Nothing. Thank you.
All right.
That was perfect.
Thanks.